The diagnosis of early developing celiac disease should be based on a combination of clinical features, histology, serology, and genetics. Conventional histology is not anymore a gold standard in the diagnosis. The diagnostic criteria need thus to be revised. This is in the American Journal of Gastroenterology, saying that doing biopsies is not the gold standard anymore, because that's an end stage. The diagnosis of early developing celiac disease should be based on a combination of clinical features, histology, serology, and genetics. The major celiac-producing genes, predisposing genes, are located in the HLA region, human leukocyte antigen region, and it's HLA-DQ2. 90% of the patients or more have DQ2, and the other 10% or so have DQ8. Some have both. HLA-DQ2 or DQ8 was detected in every early developing celiac patient. Celiac patients are 10 to 15 times more likely to exhibit IgA deficiency. IgA deficiency, so if you're just checking IgA, you might miss it because they're 10 to 15 times more likely to have an IgA deficiency. Their systems are worn out. They can't produce IgA anymore.